So today we're going to talk a little bit about classification within the hierarchies of different biological organisms. This is very, very common asked question, you know, in basic biology and college biology and high school biology. I've written them in order here, and I've actually separated the domain. As you can see, it's kind of in it's separated from the rest of these. That's because they just recently added domain. I'm not sure when, but it's usually in the past, it's just been kingdom down. But anyways, this is kind of an inclusive system, or, it groups it into an inclusive category. As you can see here, kingdom is the most broad, with species being the most specific. So there'll be like six kingdoms, and then within the kingdom, there'll be phylums, and within the phylum, there'll be class, and, so on and so forth. To say it again, species is the most specific and kingdom is the most broad. A good way to memorize this, there's a lot of mnemonics out there, but the one that I like is king, and then Phillips came over for good Snooky. You can add does King Philip come over for good Snooky, or maybe for the domain, but there's a lot out there. You can do your own research if you don't like mine. Anyways, down here I've written two different names, and this is actually how we classify different organisms. We use the genus, and then we use the species, which is the most two specific of the the classifications. And so the Artemisia here, that is the genus, and the Tridenta here, that is the species. And as you can see, the genus is actually capitalized, but the species is not capitalized. And this is how we, usually do this when we see scientific articles and those kind of things. This way we can see, oh, okay, what's an organism, what's a medicine, what's a pharmacological, component or something. But anyways, the way that we can tell is it's either italicized or it is underlined. But in both situations, the genus is capitalized and the species is undercase.